Welcome to another Mathologer video. Today's mission is to do nothing. Well, sort of. Today we'll reveal the secrets of the mysterious trammel of Archimedes, also known as the nothing grinder. This gadget here is the basic model, but there are many more complicated incarnations. Lots of really satisfying visual aha moments and beautiful mats coming your way. Enjoy. Okay, let's have a look at what this thing does. And yes, at first glance, it really does seem to do nothing. It just spins and spins like a particularly pointless fidget spinner. Hence the colloquial name nothing grinder or do nothing machine. A lot of people even call it the bullshit grinder. I did not make this up, promise. But first impressions can be misleading. Let's zoom in to have a closer look. Here I've highlighted the point on the arm exactly in the middle between the two screws. What curve do you think it draws? Well, of course, anytime someone asks you that, it's a good bet that the answer is a circle. And it sure looks like a circle. And looks are not deceiving. Yep, it's a circle. Neat, huh? Here I've marked a couple more points along the arm. The blue button traces a perfect ellipse, and so do all the other buttons. Now, of course, ellipses are some of the most fundamental curves in mathematics and nature, with planets zooming around the sun on elliptical orbits and so on. Turns out the do-nothing machine produces ellipses of all possible shapes. Super neat, don't you think? Mathematically, probably the easiest way to construct all ellipses is to simply squish a circle in one direction. For example, here are the ellipses that we just saw produced by the nothing grinder. All right, neat, huh? Here's a puzzle for you. Given one ellipse of a particular shape, say the blue ellipse, how many points on the arm of the nothing grinder trace an ellipse of the same overall shape? Here I'm assuming, in typical mathematical denial of reality, that the arm is in fact an infinitely long ray that continues beyond where the physical arm stops. Share your thoughts in the comments. Now, since ellipses are super important, and since nothing grinders are super good at drawing them, is there maybe a practical use for our nothing grinder? Well, not so much now, but in the good old pre-computer days, the ellipsograph was indeed a standard and important mechanical drawing tool. So there's a picture of a really beautiful antique ellipsograph. You can adjust the positions of these bits over there to draw ellipses of many shapes and sizes. Here's a different nothing grinder, featuring three sliders instead of two. Mesmerizing, isn't it? Also pretty amazing when you think about it. Two linear sliders giving 2 degrees of freedom to allow the arm to spin in a fixed way makes sense. But how come it is possible to insert a third linear slider into the setup without the whole thing seizing up? Oh, and by the way, I 3D printed the model over there, and I'll link to 3D printable STL files of this and other nothing grinders in the description. Some early Christmas presents for all of you. These models print out perfectly without adding any supports on my monster Zortrex 3D printer, but mileage will almost certainly vary depending on what sort of printer you have. Let me know in the comments if you succeeded in printing a copy. Okay, so what sort of curves does this more complicated do-nothing machine trace? What do you think? Maybe it's a little surprising, but nothing new happens. This thing also traces ellipses and nothing else. So the three screws you see here are the corners of an equilateral triangle, and the midpoint of this triangle again traces a circle. Unfortunately, my aim was slightly off when I pushed the pink pin in, and so we don't see a perfect circle here, but a slightly squished one. All very pretty, but where do these circles in the middle come from? Why can you have more than two linear sliders? And why all those ellipses? I know, you won't be able to sleep tonight unless you know the answers to these questions, so let me inflict some really beautiful and surprising explanations on you. What do you see? A little circle of points rolling inside a large circle. Sure, but do you also see a bunch of lines? No? Let's make it clearer. Whoa, I bet you did not see that one coming. Really amazing, don't you think? I still remember being very taken by this the first time I saw it. So what's going on here? This phenomenon is known as the 2C couple, named after its discoverer, the 13th century mathematician and astronomer Nasir al-Din al-Tusi. Regular mathologerers will remember the 2C couple from our recent video on epicycles and Fourier series. If a circle rolls inside a circle of twice the size, then any point on the circumference of the small circle traces out a diameter of the larger circle. Super duper pretty. That's exactly what you see in this animation. 8 points on the circumference of the small circle tracing diameters of the large circle. And when we focus on just these 2 diameters here and the points moving on them, we're looking at an exact replica of our original nothing grinder. The 2C couple also makes it clear at a glance why a nothing grinder can have as many linear sliders as we wish. So another way of looking at this animation is to interpret it as a nothing grinder with 8 sliders and with pivot points evenly placed around an invisible rolling circle. Here is a 6-point grinder I printed, complete with the stationary large circle and a small rolling circle. It's also now really easy to see that the midpoint of the pivot points is tracing a circle. Why? Well, this midpoint is the center of the rolling circle, which of course traces another circle. At the end of the video, I'll also explain where all those ellipses come from and why the 2C couple does what it does. But before I do this, here's a quick show and tell of some other pretty stuff. Here again is the basic setup with the rolling circle highlighted. Let's first play with the position of the pivot points on the rolling circle and move them inside the circle. All right, here we go. Then, as shown, instead of line segments, these pivots will now trace ellipses. This means that we could have the sliders run in elliptical grooves instead of straight grooves and still have a smoothly working nothing grinder. So let's just have a look at this. That's what it would look like. Next, if we modify the size of the rolling circle, other interesting things start happening. Here we go. Okay. Let's roll. Yep, it's spirograph time. If we have both sliders moving along the red trefoil groove, then other points on the arm trace rounded triangles. And we can get rounded squares and pentagons and a lot of other spirographic curves that I talked about in the epicycle video. The 3D printing part of all this is still work in progress, but you can see I'm having a lot of fun again. Now, to mathematically round off things, let me show you where all those ellipses come from. We begin with the familiar unit circle in the familiar xy plane. Head out from the origin at an angle theta, then the point on the circle has x coordinate cos theta and y coordinate sine theta. Now let's stomp on the circle, squishing it into an ellipse. This amounts to multiplying the y coordinate by some small scaling factor a. As theta varies, the point sweeps out our ellipse, and so this gives a parameterization of the ellipse. The theta is the theta of the original circle. We can still clearly see the x coordinate cos theta of the original triangle in the ellipse. So there we go. We can also visualize the y coordinate in a scaled down triangle with hypotenuse a, like this. Ponder this for a moment. All under control. Great. Now, just bring these two triangles into alignment and the do-nothing machine materializes right there in front of our eyes. Now, as we change the theta, the arm traces our ellipse. Super neat and very natural, isn't it? And what this also shows is that our picture that goes with the standard parameterization of an ellipse is a natural generalization of the picture that goes with the standard parameterization of the circle that most of you will have done to death in school, right? Let's go back and forth a couple of times. Really pretty, isn't it? So, unbeknownst to you, every time you drew the circle diagram, you were just a mini step away from understanding the fabulous do-nothing machine. Recently, 3blueronbrown did two nice videos in which he talked ellipses. What I just showed you also makes a nice addition to these videos, so definitely also check out the 3blueronbrown videos if you haven't seen them yet. And that finishes the official part for today. Hope you enjoyed this video. But for those of you who like their maths to be even more mathsy, stick around a little longer and I'll show you a pretty visual proof that the 2C couple draws straight lines. Okay, here's the starting position for the little rolling circle. I want to convince you that the red point will really run along the orange diameter. Well, let's roll it a little bit. So if L2C is correct, where in this picture should the red point now be? Well, obviously here on the orange diameter. How can we prove that it's really there? Well, what we have to show is that these two arcs along which the two circles have touched during the rolling action have the same length. But remember that the larger circle has twice the radius of the smaller circle with proportionally larger arcs. So to prove that the green and red arcs are the same length, we simply have to show that this green angle here is half this red angle. But showing that the red is twice the green is easy. Here's the first green angle inside the red one. There we go. Now here's an isosceles triangle with pink sides equal. And that means we also have a green angle over there. But then this zigzag here shows that we've got yet another green angle here. And so two green angles make a red. Ta-da, the magic of maths. And that's really it for today.